Hello everybody, Katharina Raven here, also known as Kraven. I'm back. If you've never been to my channel, welcome. And if you have been here before, I'm doing something different. So Lesserafim is coming out with their first studio album called Unforgiven. Since I also dabble in photography, I really want to talk about the Bloody Rose concept photos because they are fire and they actually remind me a lot of my own work. This photographer is so dope. Their name is Jisuk. I started following them on Instagram immediately. So I'm loving how beautiful and ominous this entire project is. There's a lot of religious undertones with the angel wings and the heart on the chest, which is definitely giving like Sacred Heart of Jesus. So a lot of religious undertones, which I think adds to that kind of ominous feeling. I also love that this concept is called Bloody Rose when there's actually no roses throughout this entire thread of photos, but I mean they have like little bruises and band-aids, so I'm guessing maybe they're the roses that are bloody. I don't know, we'll get into that. But look at this photo. I love the way that it's set up. I love the composition with this negative space up here, and the entire middle section of the photo is just all of their faces. You go straight to Chae-won in the middle. Just really good lines. Beautiful, beautiful. I love the two. Actually, there's four extras. 1, 2, 3, 4. I feel like the extras really help enhance this entire series. Like, it just really gives it that ominous vibe. Like, again, we can't see their faces. And if you guys have followed me by now, you know I love a good ominous kind of goth vibe. That's my thing. Love this photo. The contrast is just so intense. Like, the blacks are so black. And the only thing lighting them is that fire, and it just looks so culty. Interesting. So another reason why I love the Bloody Rose series is because it also gives me that like Renaissance painting type of vibe, which is something that I really love. Especially when I do photography, I'm always trying to put in a little bit of that like Italian Renaissance or Baroque or Northern Renaissance style into my work. And one of the ways that you can do that is by having like a single point light setup. So instead of having like backlight, a key light, a fill light, it's just one light. And that totally is so reminiscent of the painting days where there was just one light, and it's just super soft. You can see here the shadows on their faces are very soft. Everything is looking so smooth. Another reason why this gives me that like picturesque painting vibe is because the colors are very muted, they're very soft, and there's not that many colors throughout the entire piece. You know, we got a little bit of pinks here, and then the rest is just like black and whites, and of course a little bit of their skin tones. But I think when you have that desaturated look, it also can lend itself to looking like a painting. Also, the composition here is beautiful. They are just stacked together. Again, there's more extras, again faceless people. And their eyes are just popping. Like, look at Unche's eyes. Popping. This one is so cool. Like, I have no idea what's going on. I think some people are saying that, like, this is Sakura and this is Unche. Love it. This one is so cool. I love this. This is where the ribbons come into play. I love this, like, I don't know if it's called double exposure or overlapping photos, long exposure. It just kind of gives that, like, really creepy vibes. Like, you can't look at this and say this doesn't look like a horror film poster. Like, it's giving horror. Especially, like, look at Chae-won. You can see she has like three faces here. 1, 2, 3. And then Unche, dude, she looks like the girl from The Grudge right here. Like, look how cute and ominous she looks. And all these ribbons. So creepy. It's giving me like Ring Around the Rosie plague type. I don't know. Okay, so now we're getting into the solo series. I love this shot of Chae-won with the bow and arrow. Look at the milky clouds, and then we have like these little dots on the frame, and it just really gives it that like papery textured, again, like a painting maybe on canvas type of feel. And again, the colors are very muted. We have pops of the pink, a little bit of blue, and then just some yellows. Very simple color palettes, and it just looks so gorgeous. The editing style is phenomenal. I like how the lines from the eye patch just make it so that you want to look straight into her eye. Her eye's like almost in the center of the frame. We got these lines leading her fingers. Everything's kind of telling you, look at her eye. This is very creepy too. Like, We can't see their faces, but we know that they are staring directly at her. And she's staring directly at us while cutting her hair. It's just so intense, so creepy. I don't know. And their little bloody fingers, like, I love this type of stuff. When it looks beautiful, but it's actually really kind of like messed up or like creepy or dark or like mysterious. I love this film strip of Chaewon. You can see there's like a progression of her getting more and more hurt, more and more bandages until she gets this eye patch. And then I'm like, oh my, like, what is she going through? All right, now here's sweet little Unche, our little Magne. Very cute. Love the little band-aid. She's got the closed eye. We're going to talk about that later. This shot is awesome. Again, very, very intense. They're like sardines packed. And she's just staring straight up at us. Like, so intensely. She has this, like, I feel like out of all the girls, she has a more mischievous vibe. Like, I feel like all of her photos kind of lend itself to mischievousness. Like, she's, like, totally against the pack. She's not doing what anybody else is doing. And she's looking you dead in the eyeball. But when she, versus, like, when Chaewon does it, something about her face looks way more intentional. It's another overlapping shot. And I love how there's still only just one single heart. Beautiful. Like, look at her face in this third one. Like, she's kind of smiling and, like, looking out. It's so creepy. I love it. This one is my favorite Unche photo. They're using such a compressed, like, telephoto lens so that everybody looks so close together, so tightly squeezed together. And we're just getting back of head, back of head, back of head. And then all of a sudden, there's just one person. And it's just one little intense eyeball. Just looking dead at you. It's like, ooh, why is she going against the grain? Why is she staring at me? Why is she just like in a totally different position from everyone else? And she looks so mischievous about it. Do you guys agree with me? If you agree with me, put like a little baby and like a little devil emoji. Okay, now moving into Kajua's photos. Her photos to me seem way more innocent. I can't tell if there's like a character or if Lesserafim has a storyline, kind of like how TXT has Star Seekers. I'm not sure. If you know, comment, let me know. But she has like stars where the other girls have like hearts, bow and arrow, stuff like that. And a cool thing about this photo is there's even a little, her catchlight in her eye, they shaped it as a star. That's such a cute, awesome detail. I think that looks so good. This photo right here is one of my favorite photos. I love the composition, the lighting, the pose, everything. If you see here, we have the negative space on top, that wall. We have all of this darkness of just the bodies that are in the shadows. And we're using one light at the bottom shining up at her from below. And it creates that shadow that's so big and reaching behind her on the wall. I love the pose. Everything is telling you to look center frame. If you see here, the star is center of her chest. The star is in the center of this entire photograph. Their arms, everything is leading. So many lines along with the lighting are telling you to look at that star. And this is such a well-composed photo. Like, it could be any other framing. Like, it could be cropped in like this or cropped like that. But I think this, like, extra space at the top and bottom just really lends itself to that Renaissance type of painting vibe. That's what I'm picking up on, at least. So yeah, I really feel like Kajua has this like kind of savior, which is interesting because again, with the references, the religious references with Jesus, you know, Jesus is like a savior. I don't know. That's just me. That's just my opinion. I also find it really interesting that when we think about Jesus, we think about forgiveness, but the album's called Unforgiven. Coincidence? I also love this photo of Kajua because she is the only one that we see using the scissors to cut the ribbon. And when I see ribbon, it always makes me think of like cutting away metaphorical ties. Whereas in Chaewon's photo, she's cutting her hair, which is way more like, okay, I'm not good. I'm not in a good place. Here we see her cutting away the ribbon and it looks more freeing. Like she's kind of releasing herself from something. Also, another thing that I love that her scissors are pointing right towards the cornea of her eye and the ribbon is covering this eye. So again, we got a lot of places to look at. Like one of the first places that my eyes goes to is her hand because of the lighting. And then that takes you straight to her eye and then back to this ribbon, that strip of that fuchsia. beautiful photography here. So yeah, again, I just feel like Kajua just has this like savior, more angelic vibe to her. Her faces are softer. Nothing here feels very ominous at all. This is Sakura. One thing that I noticed in Sakura's photos, she has this little bandage on her heart. I thought that was interesting. A lot of the other members don't have bandages on their heart. I love how they made her entire pupil into the heart shape. Such a cool, fun detail. This photo is so interesting to me. Like, most of it is blurry or out of focus, but it's still such a beautifully composed photo. This is my favorite photo of Sakura. I love it. She's like holding this probably cell phone with that red lighting, and it's just right on her face. It is very creepy and very pretty at the same time. And again, the extras just in place, staring forward. We're just seeing backs of heads, and she's looking at dead into the camera. Okay, now for our girl Yunjin. Love this photo. The lighting is way more straight on her face, a little bit brighter. We have like these water droplets or something maybe in front of the camera. There's like maybe a piece of glass or something. I'm not terribly sure. This photo is crazy. It's the most different out of all of the photos in this series. And I'm like, okay. So that kind of makes me wonder, there definitely has to be some sort of storyline or something going on. Like, her wings are on fire. She's definitely giving like fallen angel. Look at this red, like it looks very hellish compared to the other photos. And she's got that eye patch. And what's also interesting about her photo is that she has this broken heart in the mirror. And first of all, broken mirrors always kind of give you that bad luck feeling. And on top of that, we're seeing her face is distorted. There's parts of her that are distorted. Out of all the characters, I would say that Yunjin's is probably the one in the most trouble or being troubled. I don't know. Does that make sense? I love this photo. So beautiful. The hair, the lighting, her face, her eye. And again, she's got a little arrow pointing in her heart when no one else does. So I'm like, wait, did Chaewon shoot her? Like, why does she have an arrow? She's the only person that has an arrow in her heart. And then again, we see Sakura with a bandage on her heart as if she has been shot before. Interesting. Some of the themes that I'm seeing throughout this entire series is the single eye or the eye patch. So I'm definitely interested to know what that kind of means. So my top two photos in this entire Bloody Rose series is this shot, this group shot, amazing, and the Kazuha shot. Like, this is phenomenal. I wish I took this photo. Speaking of, I wanted to show the Instagram page of Cho Ki-sook. It's beautiful, beautiful work. I don't know if this is a woman, if this is a man, it doesn't matter. Look at this photography. Definitely go follow this photographer. You can see so many of those similar themes that they used for this photo shoot in their work. So they definitely have been doing this theme before they worked with Lesserafim, which I think is even more dope. And also, if you feel inclined, I'm definitely not as amazing as Ki-sook, but definitely go follow me on Instagram too. You can see some of my work there. I would love that. Message me, hit me up. If you made it to the end of the video, please comment with a heart emoji with the arrow going through it so I know that you made it this far. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, maybe learned a thing or two. I will see you in the next video.